Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Cracker Barrel. My bank account is narrow. Welcome. My name's Drunk Boy Troy. I'm the host for tonight's show. This is King the Dean right here.
Hey, what's up, everybody?
Yeah.
Hey. You're done.
Hold on, man. Is our mics on? Hold on.
Yeah, man. Our mics on, man.
Oh, alright.
All right, so everybody, welcome to the Cracker Barrel.
I'm the host, alright.
Oh yeah, I'm so sorry, man.
Alright, first genre, we need to hurry up, man. First genre is music. What's your favorite music to listen to?
Oh, by God, man, by God.
Yeah.
I mean, if I had to choose one thing to listen to...
Well,
it's Lil' Cumtism, man. That man is amazing.
Yeah. I like that one bar, belt buckle, made him chuckle. I like that line.
Yeah, that man inspired me that I even used that bar in that Fear and Fridays poem.
Yeah. But, you know, I mean, my music, I get very lyrical. But let's talk about that new Drake album. I mean, I'm tired of hearing that singing shit. I mean, buddy, I mean, just do some trap, buddy. No one wants to hear you singing the KK, make me want to kiss you. I don't know what the fuck he said. But
man.
I don't want to hear about that. I want to hear about the nitty gritty, getting out of the shooting.
Oh, that really, what's it called? It's that thing that Peter said in that one Family Guy episode. Oh, yeah, it really grinds my gears.
It grinds my gears, yeah. That's what I was saying. It grinds my gears.
Like, why does he have to sing in every single song? Like, there just gives like a 2 out of 10 for me.
Yeah, I mean, son. I mean, people out there like that singing Drake, but it's fine. I don't care if you like Nicki Minaj, buddy, but all I'm saying is that rap Drake, buddy, when he starts rapping, oh my God, but I get to another gear, you know?
Well, before we move on to the next topic, I just want to let you all know that we are actually, well, I'm actually collabing with Quantavious for an album. That's right. The album's name is Album. I know, man. And
yeah.
Drunk Boy Troy's also helping out.
Yep. Need some of the titles. I'm even going to be on one of the songs. Maybe two, maybe three, buddy. So, Cornhound, me, Quantavious, if you want me to be on. But nonetheless, yeah.
Yeah.
But do you know
man,
what's
we should honestly get a Quantavious on the podcast.
Yeah. Do you know when that album's dropping, or just like whenever?
Man, probably in about 2-ish weeks, maybe even sooner than that.
2-ish weeks, okay. How many songs is going to be on? Can you tell us how many songs is going to be on it, or is that...
Man, it's going to be a thick one, man. It's going to be a thick one.
Thick, man. Thick.
He's like my wife,
dude. Yeah, well, so you know our record labels. We got... We got all the Drakes. You know Drake, right? The guy owns my record label. We got everybody on that.
Yeah.
Then we got King the Dean and XO. Out of all those artists, if you're in a car and you're with your shawty and she's, you know, has your boobs out. What the fuck are boobs?
My boobs? I don't have boobs, man.
I wasn't talking to you. Talking about your girl. What song are you playing if your girl's in that room? Like, what are you gonna play? Like, you know?
I know I might be a little, I might come off as a little bit biased, but
okay, Sean.
I have to go with King the Dean, man. Like my
oh
music
my God.
Just it's perfect, man. It gets me in the mood every single time I listen to it, man.
Favorite song?
My God,
what's favorite song of yours, man?
It's kind of between my Fear and Friday's poem,
and
the Sesame Street one.
God, them songs are shit. Our favorite election night was the studio, but then he got a
lot. Oh, man.
My ears almost fall
off.
That's
rude.
It sucks so bad. But no, I'd probably go with one of my songs. I feel like it gets into the person's heart more than the others. We got what's that one song? We got Ha Ha, I'm Funny. The list goes on. We got Papa's Pizzeria, one of my clap favorites right there.
Oh, yeah, that's a good
one. My favorite album is Fortnite Gun. I don't know if you OGs remember it, but buddy, I went hard on that.
I wish I was on that one.
Yeah, you liked it? You liked it?
Yeah, man, I especially like that one collab you did with what's that guy's name? Loud Ronnie, yeah.
Loud Ronnie, yeah.
Man, I'm really glad I finally started, like, oh, you good, man?
God, I'm mine, though. I can hear you.
I'm really glad that I stepped out of my comfort zone and, like, actually put on my real voice. Like, all right,
next segment.
Talk.
Number two, favorite game.
Oh,
what's
man.
Your favorite game to play, Kane? What's it going to be, man?
Man, like, I would say Spider-Man 2, but come on, man.
Yep.
I'm not that big of a fan of Spider-Man.
I am, yep.
So, what's that called? I have it on my PlayStation right here.
Got it on it? All right, let's hear it, man. What is it?
What's it called?
The fans
I'm not
are
sure
dying,
if this released
you?
This year or not, but by the game I have a gun.
Wait, what's
like,
it
that
called?
Game, that game's pretty cool.
Is that what it's called?
Yeah, by the game I have a gun.
Wait, it's called by the game I have a gun. Wait, is that for now?
Yeah, man.
Wait, what's it called? Is that for now?
By the game I have a gun.
Wow, that's your favorite?
Well, it's either between that and, what's it called? I mean, you can never go wrong with the Grand Theft Auto 6, I mean 5.
Yeah. Honestly, my favorite game was, I don't know about you, but I'm a Wii player. You know, I like the Wii.
Yeah, man.
My favorite game I played recently, I don't know if you've seen it, Outlast. I love that
part
game,
three.
Man. No, that part one on the Wrap It Up channel. You ain't seen that? You ain't seen the video yet?
No.
Well, yeah, I was on our, there was like this big dude that killed me, buddy. I was trying to hide in the locker and out of nowhere, he busted through the door and just,
Outlast.
Yeah.
Oh.
And then it bugged it. It didn't save my progress.
I mean, I thought you said The Last of Us.
The Last of Us.
Yeah.
No, Outlast, man. Outlast.
God, that game's scary, man. I once pooped my pants just like before he got in the daggone asylum, man.
Are you an Xbox, PC, PS4, PS5, Wii? What kind of play? What kind of game
man,
are you?
Xbox or PCs?
Like, I'm guessing you're.
I'm more of that Nintendo Switch player, but every now and then I do hop on PlayStation.
Nintendo Switch?
Yeah, buddy.
Isn't that for little bitches? Like, Nintendo Switch, man. Man, you can buy his console with that Nintendo Switch.
Man, it has been a long time since I played on the Switch.
Well, what are you playing, buddy? You haven't ever listened to me.
PlayStation, dude.
I thought you said you played Nintendo Switch.
Yeah, I was upset, dude. PlayStation every now and then.
Oh, okay. Well, have you ever played The Last of Us series?
I played the third game.
Oh my god, man. I don't know who doesn't know this, guys, but Joel dies in part two. And, buddy, I died laughing when he dies, man. I'm like, man, you deserve that, you old motherfucker. Yeah.
Man, Man, I was going to buy that game. Screw you.
Oh, you know what happened?
No. I played the third game. He got me so hyped.
Third? Wait, huh?
Yeah, The Last was part one.
You said part three, son.
No, that was like they released that after part two.
Oh my god. Son, are you dumb?
They're confusing me.
Son, they're not confusing, son. I think you're misunderstanding right now. Listen, you dumb motherfucker. It went last of his part.
Oh, motherfucker.
Oh, my God.
I was getting my 50 pound belt buckle.
Major Chave, whatever you said. So it goes part one. That came out in 2008. Then we got part two. Now, keep up with me. They released part one remastered. You see where I'm going with
that? That's what I was talking about, man.
Son, that's still part one. It's just a remastered version of it. It's not number
three. Yeah, I didn't play like the older one. I only played newer one.
Oh, okay. So, but you never played part two?
No.
Oh, shoot. So I spoiled it. Joe dies for you?
Yes, fuck you.
I mean, Ellie survives. Well, now they know she survives. My bad.
Man, oh my god.
I can't spoil stuff. Oh my god.
Alright, best movie of all time.
My job, but okay. Best movie of all time. Now, see, this topic for me is one of those like, what's your favorite food? Right? There's too many options. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's like going to a store or going to a gas station and saying, what snack do I want?
What piece of backer do you want?
I don't chew backer. That gets in your teeth.
Yeah, I mean, I got used to it, man. Like, I got a bunch of hoes that I just, like, stick back in there and you just, like, yank it out.
Yank it out.
I'm not sure how I did that seedy voice earlier in my career.
Wait, just off track for a moment. Where do you live?
Man, good old Mississippi. Wait, no, that's my cousin.
Oh, cousin,
dude. Hey Siri.
So hurry up. We got a topic,
located near Tennessee? Alright, I'm at Kentucky.
You didn't know where you lived.
Oh, man. Hey, all that tobacco just brought into my noggin, man. I'm sorry.
It might not sound like it, but I'm from California.
California?
Yeah, I live here. I just got a country accent ever since I've been born. I wasn't even around one. But yeah, back to
it. Like, I don't even know how I can do a good country. Well, city voice, man. You know what I'm talking about, man? Oh, God.
All right, best movie of all time. What are you thinking?
Man. Hey, what's that called? It's where this bitch is getting chased down by a bunch of aliens.
Bunch of aliens?
Yeah, man.
Talking about white chicks?
No.
Oh, is that new movie came out?
Was it new? I remember watching it back when Endgame came out.
I think you're thinking The Black Phone. I think that's what you're thinking about.
Oh, yeah, Black Phone, that's
Black
it.
Black Phone, of course I see it. That was that
man, movie. Whenever that one kid tried to reach down the sink, and like his hand got cut up on alien's arms, like, man, that's pretty cool, man.
Yeah, that was pretty cool. I remember watching that at school.
Man, what kind of school did you go to, man?
It was a public.
All public.
Yeah,
man, I man. You know what gets on my nerves?
What?
Private school kids. That's right, man.
Oh, my God. But it don't even get me started.
Oh, my God, man. See, they got me stuttering and everything.
Yeah, I can tell you.
Let's move on from that.
Okay, shit. But, yeah, my favorite movie of all time, you know, there's many of them. There's plenty. But I like, man, there's, like I said, it's going to a gas station. Picking one of your favorite snacks. It's impossible. Right? But
what is a movie, though? Like, what's defined as a movie?
You know, like a movie that lasts about an hour, you know, two. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but I pull up YouTube and I click on viral TikToks of October. And so is that a movie? Because I'm watching something. It's like an hour long.
Something about one you go to the theater and look at, you know, you watch and all that.
Oh, right.
Well, you know, my favorite movie's probably Home Alone 2. You know, whenever that kid's home alone. Parents suck, man. This made the second time in a row where they left their son in the house when we went on vacation. Have you seen it before?
Why? They left him inside the house?
I said, all right, so what happened, right? So he was supposed to go on a flight with them to somewhere, I think, like Mexico. And he accidentally went on the wrong flight. And he ended up in New York.
Man.
So his parents are in Mexico while he's in New York City.
Dude, I thought he left the parents in the house. What did I remember?
You're probably thinking of something like, what kind of movie would you,
I was thinking it was called A Home Together. Daggone it, man.
Huh? Oh, probably Daddy's Home. Was that what you was thinking of?
No.
Wait, what were they of?
This whole entire time, man. I thought Home Alone was called Home Together for the longest time, man.
Home Together? No. But yeah, Home Alone 2, I love those movies. He, like, traps some criminals, and he gets, messes them up, comes in her house, and boom, just starts smacking the shit out of them dudes, man. He just gets down to gritty old business to them.
Yeah, man.
You know what I mean? Yeah, it's like, it's crazy, son. All right, next topic. Are ghosts real? Now, buddy, I don't know.
Well, I don't mess with those heebie-jeebies, man.
I don't know about you, but I feel like every time I think of ghost, I'm like, oh, there's one behind me. You know what I mean? Have you ever been to bed?
I just cranked my neck.
Oh, you just cut me off, you motherfucker. All right, so like you know when when you're on the bed or something, right? Like you're cuddled up, it's cozy, which is titty, you know? And like, one little toe's hanging off. You know what I mean? Like, one little toe. And like, oh, there's a ghost gonna get that, you know?
Man, one of these days, I was fearing for my life, man. Mm-hmm. I get out of the shower, I drop my towel.
Drop your towel.
I go to pick it back up, and no matter how much it doesn't happen, deep down inside, I always think that my reflection's not going to move, man.
Really?
Yeah, like, I'm twitching in my boots just thinking of it.
Wow. I mean, let's get...
Like, what's the deal with ghosts?
Ghosts? First of all, what do you think ghosts are? They're like, ones just die, and they want to spy on you. Like, what do you think ghosts really are? I mean, for me personally, I think they're like dead people, and they're trying to communicate with you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, man. What I was thinking is maybe it's like people from other universes that reach into the wrong door and then like pulls them into another world.
Subscribe to Wrap It Up, MG. Can you?
Who's MG?
Okay.
But, it's either that or, is people just dying, man.
People dying. Well,
and like, next... there's no afterlife, really.
See, our next topic, I'm not going to say what it is yet, but, you know, sometimes I see ghosts in my dreams, you know what I mean? It's like, I feel like ghosts can follow you through the walls, through, I don't know, but I feel like ghosts are, like, you think ghosts are a good thing? They're just starting to see what's going on, not really learning to mess nothing up. What do you think? I think I hear, you know, evil intentions. What are you thinking?
Man, this is thought I had for a long time after seeing Paranormal Activity.
Yeah.
Man, how horny do you think ghosts get, man?
Oh, yeah, buddy. Yeah, but if I was a ghost, buddy, you don't want to know what I do.
Man, it's like that one scene in the Scary Movie 2.
Yeah.
Like whenever that girl laying on the bed. And then you did the
Look. She doesn't know I'm there. I'm not gonna mess nothing up with her life, buddy. Just take off your clothes and let me see it, bitch. That's all I'm here for,
buddy. Dude, that's not. We gotta keep this podcast going, man.
Man, look, we're still talking about gays, man. Just not all the kind you want to talk about.
Oh, man.
All right, but the real question, let's get straight to it. Do you think ghosts are real? Just yes or no. What are you thinking?
Man, one time when I was laying down, I felt something grab a hold of my buddy. Buddy? What?
Your buddy?
My booty.
Okay.
Man, I know it wasn't my wife because my wife left me years ago.
Well, that would make sense.
So, you know, it's to be a ghost, man. It wasn't my then.
Are you sure it wasn't you just touching yourself, buddy? You never know what you're up to.
Man, I had both my arms out like I'm like a signaling traffic.
Signaling traffic, man. Well, so your answer is yes. That the real?
Yeah.
Well, before I get to my answer, this right here what solidified it for me. So, I was in the store, you know, I was with one of my cousins, you know, just shopping around, right? And, you know, just getting all the stuff we need, watermelon, cheese, Doritos, just stuff to make taco salad out of that. Anyway,
some good old taco salad, man.
And I was coming home. And, buddy, we pulled over at the gas station, told him, yo, go in there. Give me a can of, you know, something. I don't care.
I'll be back, man. I'm going to fix me some cereal.
All right. I guess you're going to wait.
Man, you won't believe it, man. Whenever I try to go pour or send me my cereal, a daggone rat just fell out of the box like that one dashy skit, man. I swear to God. Oh, dude.
Oh, you're good, though?
You are?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, man.
Wait, so what kind of cereal? Wait, no, hold on. Let me just finish my story real quick. So... told her to go in there and get me something from the store. We asked her. And she came back out. Buddy, she had a bed sheet over. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I don't know if she was drunk at night, but she came out like, with an all white outfit. Buddy, that was not her. That was a dang ghost.
Oh my God, man.
And I told that ghost to leave, and if it didn't, buddy, I was going to pull out my Glock on it.
By God. That's what I like to hear.
You know, and if you got something to say about it, well, here's my shotgun. Fuck. You know, like, man, don't say nothing. Yeah.
Man, I just want to eat some cereal, but no. Daggone rat had infect my stuff. Have to buy some more cereal now.
See, maybe a rat was a ghost. You know, we don't know.
Man, are there such thing as animal ghosts?
I'm sure there is. Why would there be?
Man, that, next that's topic. Cool.
So, next up, last topic for today, guys. I know you want more, but craziest dream. Now, before we get into that, how do we want to define craziness? Like, by like spookiness, just plumb craziness. Like, it was just crazy.
I mean, just the way I see it is just the weirdest dream you had, or something.
Weirdest dream you've got. I mean, you'll go first for me. I don't really care who goes. Yeah.
I mean, since you're the host, you can go first, right?
All right. Okay. All right. Sure. Just put some water on my shirt. But, so, believe it or not, this is actually not a dream of mine, but it's a story, it's a dream someone told me, right?
Oh, okay.
This is the craziest dream I've just heard before that someone's told me before. So, I was sitting on a porch, and my friend started telling me this. Now, I'm going to get into it. Wait, no, I didn't have a dream. I'm going to say this dream right here. But it's a real dream. So,
okay.
I was in a city. Now, I'm not sure exactly where you were, but I was having a lucid dream. Do you know what those are? Do you know what those are?
I think so. Is it where you, wait, is that one song from Juice WRLD?
Well, yeah, but do you know what it actually is? Like lucid dreaming. Do you know what that is?
No.
That means you're able, like, you have control of your body while you're dreaming. So,
man,
for example,
cool.
Say there was a gun over there. There's a woman by it. If you wanted to, you could go get the gun and shoot her. You know, because most movies, it's like it's on autopilot. You're just watching a movie or something. But no, lucid dreaming, you're controlling that movie some. So, this dream, this dream, I was controlling that. Okay, and I was in the city.
Right.
And in that dream, Freddy Krueger and Jason Voorhees was after me. Now, they didn't come at me both at a time. It was one then another. Okay? So I'm in the city, and here comes Freddy Krueger coming after me, son. Now, I'm not sure if I was on steroids or I was just, you know, on some crazy drugs. But Freddy Krueger, he'd kill me. Said I just laughed that shit off. I just rose back from the dead. He couldn't kill me for some reason. He picked me up and put me on a stake and just penetrated me. Pause. Son, I started laughing and I just got back up. They couldn't kill me. And I was in this girl's house, buddy. Yeah, we had sex and here comes Jason. You know how weird he is for sex. He always comes during sex stuff. And,
yeah,
buddy, opens the door, kills me.
He killed you? Then how are you here?
They didn't do shit.
Oh.
Lord, I woke back up. I woke back up, and here I am. I just laughed in their face. They kept killing me, but they didn't do nothing. So, that's my craziest dream. What about you?
Man, you're mortal, wait. You're immortal.
Yeah. So, what's your craziest dream?
Man, mine's nowhere near that crazy, man. God.
Yeah.
Man, this is the weirdest dream I've ever experienced, though.
All right.
It's actually kind of sexy. In some parts, I ain't gonna lie.
All right.
Man, like, I was just I was like around I was probably like 2 years younger. Yeah, like 2 years ago, maybe. I'm not sure how I can fucking remember this shit, but.
Yeah. Like 2 years
man,
ago.
Man, I got this. Man, I had a dream of this one beautiful woman. Like, oh my God, man. If I was married, I swear to God.
What hair color?
Man, pretty sure it was like a brunette or like a little mixture of that and red.
Alright, continue.
Man, we're on this boat, man. Oh my God. Man, it was huge. Oh my.
Was it bigger than Titanic?
Man, what's Titanic?
It's that boat that drowned.
Oh, that one. Oh, yeah.
Like, yeah, most man, it drowned. It sank, yeah, like I said.
Man, it's almost as big as that one. Ain't gonna lie. Man, like, oh, I met this beautiful woman. Like, she was like an actress or something. And, oh, my God. Like, me and her had so many much sex. And, man, all over that daggum boat.
Why?
But here's a crazy thing,
was
though.
Was it a real actor or like a fake actor?
It's like a fake one, I'm pretty sure.
Faking? All right. Continue.
Yeah. But, man... Like, one of those times, she let me draw her naked. Dude.
So she got naked and she let you draw her on a piece of paper?
Yeah.
Okay.
Man, God, man, like her fucking noggers made up.
Oh, buddy. Okay.
Well, then, after that, like, they just randomly jumped to, like, a car and, like, we're, like, going at it.
Yeah.
And then, like, for some reason, she put her hand on the wall, on the window, like, and then, like, gone all the way down or something. Like, it's weird. I think she's a little bit cuckoo or something.
And we ran out of time.
Man, and also like the ship sunk down by an iceberg. Like, that's the craziest part.
Hey, did you get out alive?
No. I fucking died.
Wait. You died?
Yeah.
What? You're a ghost?
Yeah, that...
Oh,
man, that
are real.
That bitch didn't even want to save me. There was plenty of room for that daggone rat.
Alright, we have run out of time.
Oh, shoot.
You'll do the outro?
I mean, you're the host, man.
Oh, yeah. Get us out of Cracker Barrel. Our bank account's narrow. Tune in next time to hear more scary stories from me and Keith Dean.
By God.